Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line. Will all the other not quite, will all the never get it right? But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning on this absolutely stunner of a day here in the heart of the Arkansas Delta. Good golly, what a day have we got going on outside. Y'all, I woke up to 50 degrees outside, and it is already warming on up even beyond that. We're probably around 55, 56 degrees right now. Where in the world is this coming from? Y'all, this weather is so schizophrenic, it's not even funny, but it is gorgeous out there. I mean, I'm looking out my office window right now, and I mean, the sun is shining. It is gorgeous. The wind is blowing just a very little. The leaves are trickling down. I mean, y'all, it is some kind of seriously gorgeous out there. So if you have got an opportunity to get out and to get out into this sunshine, maybe you've got to run an errand, maybe you've got to just work out in your yard, whatever the case may be, let today be that day that you get outside and enjoy this incredible day. I want to say good morning to everybody as you are beginning to bring yourself on in. Say hello when you get on here, and then please go ahead and hit that share button as we seek to enlarge this ministry, and that is all up to you going ahead and clicking on that share button. That's exactly what I'm doing right now, as I'm trying to get everything situated so I can chit chat and visit and all of that good stuff. And I am almost there. Brian Ponder is on. Good morning, Brian. Hope you're doing well this morning. Hope you're enjoying the sunshine as well. Sheila Hobbs is hanging out with us this morning. Good morning, Miss Sheila. Glad you are here. I hope everything is well in the metropolis of Wynn, Arkansas, and also with Mr. Brian in the metropolis of Colt, Arkansas. So come on in here, y'all. Like I said, it is a gorgeous day. We love it. We love it. Go ahead and get her done, get her said hello, and then click that share button. Make sure you got your Bibles, you got your journals, make sure you got a good cup of coffee, because it is going to be a good day today as we look at loyalty. What does it mean to be loyal? That's going to be our topic this morning. There's our sweet friends, Tommy and Arlene. Glad to see y'all this morning. There's Miss Sandy. Good morning. Miss Sandy, how's things up on your hill this morning? Everybody good up in there? Man, it has been it has just been a good day. For some reason, my brain is kind of foggy. Miss Denise took Scruff out early this morning. She was up a lot earlier than I was. And she said that we had some morning fog. So if y'all saw that, y'all were blessed. I think that fog has migrated into between my two ears, if you just want to know the truth, because I am really, really struggling. But I studied late last night, and so that probably has a whole lot to do with it. Guys, we had a great online Bible study last night. If you missed our online Bible study, we want to encourage you to go back and just scroll down a little bit ways right here on this page and catch Larry as he was teaching our online Bible study, teaching about the gospel's freedom last night. The gospel's freedom. Good stuff. And I would encourage you, if you did miss it, to go back. Or maybe if you watched it and you want to catch some notes, go back and rewatch it again. Tonight, y'all, can't say enough. I really want to see you on campus tonight, if at all physically possible, as we are deep in our study of the rise and fall of Ephesus. And tonight it takes a hard left turn. And so I don't want you to miss this. It is going to be such good content that's coming out. It's great as we are learning the details and how things are beginning to be very neatly tied together and knit together all through the New Testament, and how many times so much of it is pointed directly at the city of Ephesus. It is just amazing, especially Asia Minor, Asia Minor in general, but really in specific, the city of Ephesus. And that is all going to kickstart at 8:30. Wow. I'm telling you guys, there's fog between my ears. At 6:30 tonight on campus, coffee bar is going to be open. You can get some hot chocolate, some cider, you know, a good cappuccino. Come on in and just come on in and fellowship with us. We're going to be at the tables. You can spread your Bibles, your journals, and everything else out. So come on in and be a part of that. And if you are providentially hindered, and we understand that, then you are most welcome to join us right here online at 6:30. Again, as I have to say this, on Wednesday nights as I am teaching, it is extremely difficult for me to respond to comments and questions that are online, and I apologize for that. But if you have questions, if you have comments, go ahead and leave them in the comments, and I will get to them after the broadcast is over. Miss Sandy, got my hip waders ready. Yes, Lord, yes. That's what I'm talking about. I mean, yes, Lord, yes. Thank you, Miss Sandy. That's what I'm talking about. The best warning for tonight is bring your hip waders and a extra snack or two and maybe a sack lunch, because we're going to dive tonight. And we might have to have just some of that extra juice or something to keep it going. Thank you, Miss Sandy. You just made my morning, sweet lady. You really did. Mm-mm-mm. Hey, we're going to get started this morning with our daily Bible verse. Here in November, as we are still focusing on daily gratitude. Daily gratitude. And we're nearing Thanksgiving. Hey, guys, 2 weeks from tomorrow is Thanksgiving Day, Turkey Day. It is upon us. 2 weeks from tomorrow. And this has been a great, great series of verses that we have been looking at thus far. And they're only going to get better. And today we find ourselves in Psalm 136. And so if you want to, go ahead and turn on over there. Psalm 136. The actual verse today is Psalm 136, verse 2. But I've just got to read a little bit more because it's just so incredible, so good. So I'm going to start at verse 1 and I'm going to read verses 1, 2, and 3. This is Psalm 136. And I'm going to read verses 1, 2, and 3 for us this morning. The psalmist writes this, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. Yes, for He is good. For His mercy endures forever. Oh, give thanks to the God of gods, for His mercy endures forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of lords, for His mercy endures forever." And the rest of that entire psalm, all of Psalm 136, is all based on Thanksgiving. And so that might be something that you want to take time today to read. And that's just to go over. There's 26 small verses, and I would encourage you to get over there and read that entire passage. It is so good, and it sets us all up for daily gratitude. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for His mercy endures forever. And to that, I say amen and amen. Guys, what have y'all got going on? We're in the middle of the week. It's hump day. Anybody got anything going on later in the week? I don't know of anything exciting that's taking place. I see Ruth Hastings has snuck in. Good morning, Miss Ruth. So glad you were here today. I'm glad that you were in. I don't know of anything that has taken place. Lord willing, we'll have our coffee chat the next couple of days at 9 o'clock, Lord willing. And then, of course, on Sunday, oh, yeah. Coffee bar and fellowship opens up at 8:30, Sunday school at 9:30, and then we're going to dive deep and we're going to worship at 10:30 on the Ridgewood campus. Would love to have you as our guest. We'd encourage you to invite others to join us as we seek to take God's Word and open it up and to apply it into our daily lives. Amen, amen, and amen. So guys, we need to get everything started this morning. So we need to make sure that our boys out in the chicken coop are fired up this morning. They wake. There we go. Y'all wake out there. Get up. Get yourselves up, y'all. Wake it up. Wake it up. It is time. We do not have time to mess around today. We got a couple of good things we want to chit-chat about today. Today, November the 10th. November the 10th is, and this is big time stuff here, okay? This is important. Today is the 246th birthday of the United States Marine Corps. And to that, I say happy birthday, Marines. Happy birthday. If you know of somebody that has given their life to the military, okay, and they are in the Marines, make sure that you reach out to them today. 246. My news feed is filled with this stuff today. I mean, it is here. Tommy, what you got going on? I'm going to Popeye's so Arlene can use my Chicken Sammy coupon. Yes, Lord, yes. Yes, Lord, yes. Hey, did anybody make it over to Popeye's or anybody and get one of those fried chicken sandwiches as we celebrated yesterday? Did anybody get to do that? I did not. Miss Denise and I did not. I studied quite a bit yesterday, but we ended up going to our new house that we're moving to next week, and we did quite a bit of cleaning. And so that was the bulk of our day and just did not. But now I did have fried chicken strips, air fried. We love an air fryer. How many of you have an air fryer? Now, come on. We're going to get down to dirt. An air fryer. I'm going to tell you something. That's the greatest invention in our kitchen that I think I have ever seen. We use our air fryer at least once a day. They are amazing. I mean, amazing. Do you have one? If you do not, you need to seriously look at getting one. Arlene says, yes. Brian had Popeye's chicken. Yes, Brian, that's what I'm talking about. Way to go, boy. Yes, sir. Brian got the throwdown on a Popeye's chicken, Sammy. Yes. No, these air fryers, though, for real, I mean, they are the bomb.com. They are so good. They're so easy. They're so much more healthy than deep frying stuff, and they're easier than baking it in the oven. They're easier, they're simpler, they're quicker. I mean, it's just a win-win-win all the way around. Brian has one. Oh yes, Kay Simpson. Well, good morning. Well, Kay Simpson, hello, welcome. We are glad that you are here. Kay, I don't believe that I know you. Thank you so much for stopping in on this morning's chat. Do you care to tell us a little bit about you? Where do you live? And how are you connected here? How did you find us? We would love to find out a little bit more and welcome and make you a part of our online family right here on the coffee chat. I'm excited. Miss Sandy says I do. See, we're talking, this is good stuff. An air fryer, if you do not have one, you need to get one. If you know of anybody that doesn't, they make a great, great gift idea. So you might want to do that. Hey, folks, right now, since Kay is kind of new to us, I just want everybody, if you will, just to give a good, warm coffee chat welcome to Miss Kay as she has snuck in here, Miss Kay Simpson. Everybody reach out and say hello to Kay and let's welcome her in this morning. We want her to be a part of us, don't we, folks? We want her right here hanging out with us for all of the foolishness, all of the shenanigans, but oh my, do we forevermore take deep dives into Scripture. Amen. I know Arlene and Tommy Allen. There we go. There's our connection. Well, thank you to Tommy and Arlene for inviting Miss Kay to join us. We love it. But everybody, right now, go ahead and jump on in there and let's welcome Miss Kay. Johnny Fletcher, I didn't know you was on here. Good morning, sweet lady. Glad you were here. Y'all's coffee, y'all hope y'all's coffee is good today. Mine is so good. Ho, ho, ho. All right. Do you remember I was one day last week, I believe it was. I made the glorious announcement that Little Debbie was coming out with Little Debbie Christmas tree cake ice cream. Do y'all remember that glorious announcement? Y'all, they have arrived. They are in grocery stores, but they are going off the shelves like this. My kids who live in Houston had to go to 3 different Walmarts yesterday in order to find them. Yes. And both my daughter and my son-in-law say, yes, yes, amen, and hallelujah. They are all about it. So they are in it. And I've seen other posts that have finally found it and are also saying just how good it is. And so if you enjoy those Little Debbie Christmas tree cakes, which I do, I can only imagine what you have that with a rich vanilla ice cream. It has to be a religious experience. I mean, it just has to be good. But they are out. So look for it in your Walmart. They're only in Walmart. In your Walmart freezer over with the other ice cream. But you're going to have to dig. I don't think they're going to be in plain sight. So you're going to have to look. And they are going to go out in a blessed hurry. So y'all, we've got to make sure that we find it. I think I'm going to splurge some this weekend. And if I find it, I'm going to try it. Okay, I'm going to try to dodge my blood sugar and try to work everything around so that I can at least get two or three spoonfuls. And to try to check it out. You know what I'm saying there, y'all? Got to try it. So, and if you try it, if you get it and try it, you got to let us know. Okay, got to let us know. Tell us where you found it, first of all. Tell us where you found it and tell us if you like it or not, okay? That's the whole key. We got to know if you like it. But, I mean, hey, it's Little Debbie Christmas tree cakes. That in and of itself is a home run. And vanilla ice cream, I mean, come on, this is a win-win, y'all. I mean, win-win. That was so good. So now I'm going to roll on into round number two. Get that bad boy out the way. November the 10th, it is also, and speaking of Little Debbie Christmas tree cakes, today is also National Vanilla Cupcake Day. National Neller Cupcake Day, which really kind of goes right along with that. So everybody needs to make vanilla cupcakes today, right now. Some put sprinkles on them. You can put anything you want on them. Cream cheese icing is by far the favorite. A good rich buttercream icing would be second to that. But if you get a chance, throw some vanilla cupcakes in the oven today and celebrate National Vanilla Cupcake Day. That is it. All right, guys, anything else going on today before we get started? We've already covered the announcements. We've already talked about what's going to go on. There's really not a whole lot in the news, a lot of depressing stuff, and I just said, nah, not today. We're not going to talk about it. A lot of foolishness that's going on. And I don't know about you, but I get tired of the foolishness. I mean, I just get tired of it. And so I just said, nope, we're not going to talk about it today. We had enough of that mess yesterday. Let's see here. First of all, let me check this cup of coffee, make sure that it is just right. Boy, Miss Denise has locked me down. I mean, it is good stuff. Brother Jim, do you have new glasses? That is an incredible observation, Tommy. These are, they are different, okay? These are my study glasses. These are what I wear when I spend an obsessive amount of time in front of a computer screen and in front of books. But they are not my normal daily out and about glasses. My normal glasses are complete solid black. And they're more of a square. So these are what I call my study glasses. They never leave my desk. They're always right here. Now, occasionally I'll forget I've got them on and I'll run uptown or something. But these are what I, when I'm studying, when I'm in deep study, I've got these on. And which, by the way, that is my day today. Today is a deep study day. And I really wish that I could get outside in this yard today, but I'm just not going to be able to. We are so far into Ephesus, and I've got to make sure that everything is wrapped up tonight. So I can't get outside in that. Having said that, there was something. Greg McDougal sneaking into my house. What in the world are you doing, Greg? Good to see you, buddy. Good to see you. Hope all is well. Hope you are gaining your strength back. Our prayers are with you. Thomas says, keep them on. They make you look intelligent. Well, you know something? I need all of that I can stand there, Brother Tommy. I need all of that I can stand. I can do it. Hey, guys, y'all know we got storms coming in overnight. Miss Denise, what'd you tell me? Between 1 and 4 a.m.? Yeah. So overnight, guys, we do have rain coming in. There is a little bit of storm pattern with it, so you do want to be careful. Supposed to hit our area sometime around 1 o'clock in the morning. should be over with before 4 or 5, something like that. So long, long before we get to the chat in the morning. So if you do have errands, you do want to get out today. And of course, as you know, Arkansas weather, that thing could change in a blessed heartbeat. So it could be here at any time overnight, and it could last half the day. So just be careful, okay? Keep your weather sirens up in case something goes wrong. And it's warm already today, which that's not really a good sign as it's warming up, because the warmer the temperature, the greater the chances of the intensity of the storms. So with it already pushing 60 right now, we got to be careful, okay? So just keep your eyes open, all that good stuff. All right, folks, y'all ready? Let's head over 2 Samuel chapter 15. Go ahead and grab your Bibles and jump on over. It is good stuff. 2 Samuel chapter 15. Yesterday, the Exodus began out of Jerusalem with David and his faithful friends. They were leaving because word had got to him that Absalom was taking over. Absalom was going to overtake the throne and assert himself as king. A coup was coming. And so David spread word, and he had so many groups of people that followed with him. Today, we're going to look just exactly at the faithfulness of one of those men that went with him. Just one of those men. And it's not so much the faithfulness as it is the loyalty. Loyalty speaks volumes. Amen? Loyalty speaks volumes. And this is going to be showing us loyalty to the man that he knows God put in place. Even though everything else was going south, and even though the majority of the people were beginning to follow the wrong person, he stayed loyal to God's man. And let's just dive into this, and then we're going to break it apart. We're going to pick up at verse number 19, okay? Verse number 19. Remember, they're already at the gate of Jerusalem, and they're leaving out, and there's hundreds of them, okay? Verse 19. Then the king said to Ittai, that's Ittai, if you don't have your scripture in front of you, to Ittai the Gittite, "Why are you also going with us? Return and remain with the king. For you are a foreigner and also an exile from your own place. In fact, you came only yesterday. Should I make you wander up and down with us today, since I go I know not where? Return and take your brethren back. Mercy and truth be with you." But Ittai answered the king and said, "As the Lord lives, and as my lord the king lives," again talking to David, "surely in whatever place my lord the king shall be, whether in death or life, even there also your servant," talking about himself, "will be." So David said to Ittai, "Go and cross over." Then Ittai the Gittite and all his men and all the little ones who were with him crossed over. And all the country wept with a loud voice, and all of the people crossed over. The king himself also crossed over the brook Kidron, and all the people crossed over toward the way of the wilderness. Okay. They have now left Jerusalem, and they've left by the hundreds. Now, we don't have an exact count. That number is irrelevant. The fact of the matter is that there was a mass exodus that followed the true king of Israel. All right, and so he has departed. And I love how David goes up to this man, and this is not he is not degrading him. He is very sincere to Ittai, because as he is watching this procession of his supporters to follow him and to follow out, here comes Ittai the Gittite. And that's the man that really got his attention, caught his eye. And so David could not understand how a man, Ittai, who just arrived with his people the day before, would still want to take the risk to stay loyal to David. David didn't get that. David did not understand that. And so what he does is he says, basically, you know, Ittai, what are you doing? You need to stay, he says, return, basically go back into Jerusalem and remain with the king. That statement by David is his admitting that Absalom is going to take over the throne. David tells Ittai to return and remain with the king. David has saw what's taking place, and he has the foresight to understand the depth of what is taking place. And he's just saying to Ittai, don't put yourself in harm's way. Don't put yourself out here with us wandering around knowing they're probably going to come after us. Be safe. You just got here yesterday. Don't do this, okay? David, by doing this, made it very clear that he is not going to cling to the throne, okay? He knows who he is, and he knows who he is in God, all right? But it was at that moment that he basically admitted that Absalom was going to succeed. And so David called him the king and left it in God's hands. In other words, God, you're going to make that decision. But here comes Ittai, and this is his response. He says, as my Lord the king lives. So he identified David as not only the king, but his king. He said, as my Lord the king lives, that it says, David, you are my king, not Absalom. I will not serve him. I will serve you. That's loyalty. That's knowing that he identifies who God put in place. And it's so hard to see that today. He says, whatever place my Lord the king, he calls it again, whatever place my Lord the king, David, you, whether it is in death or whether it is in life, then there, your servant, there's where I am going to be. Ittai was loyal to David, even though he had only been there a mere 24 hours. He knew he was God's man, and it was certain that it was probably going to cost him something. And loyalty does that. True loyalty isn't demonstrated. It's easy to be loyal until it begins to cost you something. Well, he knew that this was going to cost him. But he remained loyal nonetheless. Now, we learn a lot from Ittai. You don't read a lot about Ittai throughout the rest of Scripture. But you see, he followed David, not when David was popular and was doing great things and winning wars, and where it's easy to follow somebody when things are going good. Ittai followed and was loyal to David when David was down. That's a big difference. Ittai did it unwaveringly. He made the decision and he didn't buck from it. He knew, he stood his ground, and he followed David. He was not forced into it. Nobody forced Ittai and his people to follow David. This was all on him. This was all voluntary. That's loyalty. And he did it new to David, being new to David, but yet David's reputation had preceded him. And so it was easy, as widespread as David and David's success was, to know that he was truly God's man. He did not do it in hiding. He didn't come up to David in the secret and say, shh, don't tell nobody, but I'm going to follow you. He made it public. He made it very plain that I don't care what the rest of the thugs does in Israel that wants to follow Absalom. I'm following the real king, and I have no problem telling anybody. That's loyalty. And he did it, not knowing the ultimate fate of David. It could have cost him his life, but he did it anyway. It didn't matter. Folks, that's loyalty. We need to learn something here from that. How loyal are we to the man that God puts in place in our lives, even when things are down? It's easy to be loyal when things are going great, but it's only when things get to going the other direction is when we see the ones that are true and loyal. And Ittai defines it. He is the defining character. And they head toward the wilderness. Now, if you remember back over the past several chapters and even into 1 Samuel, David spent many months in the wilderness on the run from King Saul. You remember that? Now, we're talking years before this. So David knew what life was like in the wilderness. And do you remember? You remember the saying that I told you? That it was in the wilderness that David learned how to be king. David is going back to the wilderness. And he's taking all of these people with him. God sent him now into the wilderness again to continue that same work that was in his life. The thing I want us to catch here, though, also, and I want to go back and I want to talk about Ittai. Now, we're not talking about just Ittai, a man, okay? It's back in our scriptures that we read. It says, then Ittai the Gittite and all of his men. So we're talking about, this was a military leader, all right? And we're talking about all of his soldiers, his army, the Gittite army, followed him. But it gets more. And all his men and all the little ones. Did y'all catch that? And all the little ones who were with him crossed over the brook Kidron with David. So that means that what Ittai did, Ittai stood loyal, and he represented himself. He represented his own family. He represented his men and their families, the little ones. And his men and their families were loyal to Ittai. What a valuable lesson in loyalty comes from this. Not knowing where in the world they were going. But David knew one place that he could go to because he had been there before, that God had spoken to him. God had worked in his life. God had poured wisdom into his life and poured guidance in that was the wilderness. David knew how to survive with his men in the wilderness. And he was going back. But he's going back with, again, who knows how many people, okay? We don't know. We sincerely don't know how many people go back with David. But we do know that the ones that go back are ultra loyal. Amen and amen. Tomorrow, Lord willing, we are going to begin to see exactly what God does, how he begins to speak to David in the wilderness. You don't want to miss that. Tonight, join me, 6:30, online or on campus if you possibly can, as we continue the story of the rise and fall of Ephesus. I love you guys so very much. If you need anything, please reach out to me. I'll be glad to help you. And in the meantime, if you see anybody, tell them about Jesus. I'll see you guys tonight. Bye-bye.